In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Saturday, the 30th of September, 2023. 25th week in ordinary time, and today we remember Saint Jerome, a great saint indeed. Born in Strido in 340 AD in Dalmatia, he studied in Rome and was baptized there. He was attracted by the ascetic life and traveled to the East, where he was unwillingly ordained a priest. He was recalled to Rome to act as secretary to Pope Damasus, but on the Pope's death, he returned to the East, to Bethlehem, where, with the aid of St. Paul and others, he founded a monastery, a hospice, and a school, and settled down to do the most important work of his life, the translation of the Bible into Latin, a translation which, with some revisions, is still in use today. He wrote many works of his own, including letters and commentaries on Holy Scripture. When a time of troubles came upon the world through barbarian invasions and to the church through internal dissension, he helped the refugees and those in need. He died at Bethlehem in 420 AD. We want to pray for all the proclaimers of the Word of God that they may be dedicated, that they may spend their time and life for this Word which is alive and active through the intercessions of Saint Jerome. Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members: Bridget Tabo Corel from Lamin Wayeto, Gambia, celebrating her birthday today, text for us the first reading. Innocentia K. Mushaukwa from Katimamulilo, Namibia, celebrating her birthday today, text for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Modestus Aloisie, belonging to the congregation of the Sons of the Two Hearts of Love of Jesus and Mary, working in Sao Paulo in Brazil. Let us pray. O God, who gave the priest Saint Jerome a living and tender love for sacred scripture, grant that your people may be ever more fruitfully nourished by your word and find in it the fount of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading, I come and I will dwell in the midst of you. A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Zechariah chapter 2, verses 1 to 5 and 10 to 11a. I lifted my eyes and saw, and behold, a man with a measuring line in his hand. Then I said, "Where are you going?" And he said to me, "To measure Jerusalem, to see what is its breadth and what is its length." And behold, the angel who talked with me came forward, and another angel came forward to meet him and said to him, "Run, say to that young man, Jerusalem shall be inhabited as villages without walls, because of the multitude of men and cattle in it. For I will be to her a wall of fire round about, says the Lord, and I will be the glory within her. Sing and rejoice, O daughter of Zion, for behold, I come and I will dwell in the midst of you, says the Lord. And many nations shall join themselves to the Lord in that day, and shall be my people, and I will dwell in the midst of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, Jeremiah 31, verse 10, 11 to 12 AB, 13. The response is taken from Jeremiah 31, verse 10 D, and the response is, the Lord will keep us as a shepherd keeps his flock.
The Lord will keep us as a shepherd keeps his flock.
Hear the word of the Lord, O nations, and decree it in the island afar off. Say, he who scattered Israel will gather him, and will keep him as a shepherd keeps his flock.
The Lord will keep us as a shepherd keeps his flock.
For the Lord has ransomed Jacob, and has redeemed him from hands too strong for him. They shall come and sing aloud on the height of Zion, and they shall be radiant over the goodness of the Lord.
The Lord will keep us as a shepherd keeps his flock.
Then shall the maidens rejoice in the dance, and the young men and the old shall be merry. I will turn their mourning into joy. I will comfort them and give them gladness for sorrow.
The Lord will keep us as a shepherd keeps his flock.
Gospel acclamation. 2 Timothy verse 1 to 10. Alleluia! Our Savior Jesus Christ abolished death and brought life and immortality to the light through the gospel. Alleluia!
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 9, from verse 43b to 45. At that time, while all were marveling at everything Jesus did, he said to his disciples, let these words sink into your ears, for the Son of Man is to be delivered into the hands of men. But they did not understand this saying, and it was concealed from them that they should not perceive it, and they were afraid to ask him about this saying. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We are on Prophet Zechariah. Prophet Zechariah is post-exilic prophet. He comes after the exile experience that still left the people of the southern kingdom feeling frustrated, because all that they hoped they would find was not the case. The population had been reduced because many of them didn't come back. Even those who came back didn't find what they thought they could find. The milk and honey that was promised was not what was there. Somehow, Jerusalem looked very small. Somehow, the people didn't even count themselves as a great nation. And Prophet Zechariah comes with an assurance. The assurance is, you won't measure Jerusalem anymore. You can measure something that is small, but not something that is big. And this man says, I'm going to measure Jerusalem. This man of despair, this man who doesn't know how big is our God, goes to measure Jerusalem because he thinks Jerusalem cannot become big. There are so many people in our lives who are like this man, who think that some people will never reach anywhere. They will remain as small as they are. But here is an angel coming with a message for you and for me. Because I do have those moments of doubt, of thinking that no bigger thing can happen to my life or to anybody else's. But you know what? Our God is not a God of small things. And as he comes to make a promise, he says, you know what? Something big is going to happen. Jerusalem will have a lot of people and livestock. God is going to fill it up. You may be thinking you are empty and you're not going anywhere in your life. God is making a promise to you today in this word. Don't give up on yourself. You are going to be multiplied. I am going to work in you, says the Lord. Because the word of God is alive and active, as God did to the people of Israel in 5th century at the time Zechariah was writing this. He's going to do that to you. You are looking at your finances and they are too small to cater for your needs. God is saying you will stop counting very soon when I start blessing you. You are counting days with your own life, with your own health, because you think you're not going to manage. God is saying, I am going to multiply you. I am going to give you health such that you won't even remember that you were sick before. That's our God, and that's how he operates. But we must understand this as we wait for the God who intervenes in our lives, that suffering is part and parcel of our lives. While people were admiring all that Jesus was doing and somehow getting comfortable that this is the way life should go, Jesus says, you must understand this. Let it sink into your mind that the Son of Man is going to be delivered into the hands of those people who are going to make him face death. To make us understand that in life we will go through pain. We will go through suffering. And even when we enjoy ourselves, let us not forget that the same God of the enjoyment is the same God in our pain, in our suffering. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Saturday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word, spoken to me. And I'm desperate for you. And I'm lost without you. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your bed.